Good day, everyone. I am Aljar Presido from ARC16, and today we're presenting my research paper that I did during my senior high school. I hope you'll find this topic formative and interesting. Our study topic is titled "Till Death Will Do Art: The Disposition of Selected Senior High School Students on Visual Art as a Profession." Introduction. Since childhood, we are undeniably exposed to art. These are used to communicate or express a wide range of ideas, thoughts, and impressions, as it could be seen being displayed in museums, galleries and sculpture parks, public spaces, and even in our own homes. People often say that artists cannot make a viable career out of their passion and that they cannot make money and provide themselves if they do art. Also, in a recent survey conducted by Indeed.com.ph on July 9, 2019, results showed that the average salary of an artist in Quezon City is 16,633 per month, which is 10% above the national average, and is only the cases of employed artists in the likes and of graphic artists, advertisement designers, multimedia artists, and etc. Starving artists, a term to describe artists who strive to make in an industry, may be the reason why people acquired the thinking that there is no money in art. Next is purpose. The purpose of the research is to encourage students and not hesitate to choose art courses, to make students realize that there was a lot of job opportunities to those people who takes art courses, to promote art courses to those people who really loves art, and to lessen the perception of people that there is no money in art. Next, methodology. The researchers utilized a descriptive survey study method to collect qualitative data from Manuel S. Enverga University senior high school students. A survey is a descriptive research technique used to determine the opinions of a specific population. This is a data collecting approach in which information is obtained by oral or written inquiry. The researchers utilize open-ended questions to conduct the interview. Open-ended inquiries are intended to elicit a complete, meaningful response based on the respondent's own knowledge or sentiments. Next, sources of data. The data were based on the response of the 12 selected senior high school students from MSCUF from the academic track STEM, ABM, UMS, and GAS, and technical vocational track HE and ICT, including the arts and design track. There were two participants per strand. A purposive sample is a non-probability sample that is selected based on a characteristic, population, and objective of the study. Purposive sampling is different from convenience sampling and is also known as judgmental, selective, or subjective sampling. In this research, the participants were created on the basis of not being art student or being in the arts and design track. For the results and discussion, most of the participants thought that it is expensive and costly to pursue an art degree in the Philippines. They also wanted to find ways to make art courses more affordable. When the participants were asked why there are less art enrollees, were made to choose whether it is because there are few artists or it is because artists choose not to take it. They chose the latter and stated the reason why, such as art degrees are expensive, parents telling them that there are no future in pursuing art and they would not earn any money from it, and students choose to take courses like engineering, law, and medicine for the sake of practicality, because after 4 to 5 years, they would have a stable job and stable income. Less enrollees does not mean that there are few artists, because there are a lot. They are just not given the chance to pursue art because of the said factors that can affect the decision-making of artists regarding their college degree. Art should be promoted because it is part of the Filipino culture. According to participants, they also believe that art courses should be catered to upcoming students so that they would be reassured that there is nothing wrong in pursuing their passion. Art education can contribute to the growth of the economy. More students graduate and work as professionals. For the participants, digital art is currently the in-demand art profession in the Philippines. Despite this, some chose architecture because it is easier to find a job. It has a high salary. They also stated that there is a lot of architecture students and that people would always build houses and buildings. When asked about who has a better chance of earning between digital artists and traditional artists, the answer were divided. Almost half of them considers the fact that it is the digitalization era, while the other half thinks about how expensive the traditional arts are in exhibits and galleries. Half of the participants thought that artists do struggle financially with the reasons that it's difficult to get your piece out there. For the market for art is so saturated that are a lot of pieces being sold each day, which makes it difficult for an aspiring artist to earn money. Participants in a survey asked if there is discrimination towards artists and whether or not it is affects their income. Discrimination towards artists is widespread, especially here in the Philippines. Through the accounts of or the examples given to the participants, unfortunately, this is a big factor that affects artists' income, whether positively or negatively. Recommendation for the students: pursue your passion and don't make those illiterate people whose mindset is there's no future in pursuing art courses and be a hindrance in following your dreams. Educate your parents about the positive sides of taking art courses and there is a bright future in it. For the graduates, choose the profession where you belong and where you stand out. It's your choice to choose whether becoming a digital artist or a traditional artist. What matters is where you enjoy what you do and contented on the outcome. For the art professionals, strive harder to make the impossible things be possible. Don't let those people who belittle the value of your work be a cause to lose your confidence, affection and interest in making art pieces. That ends my presentation. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.